Hello everybody. So for this video, how I'm going to start is I'm just going to show you this app that I paid for. It's called My Phone D Back, and it basically backs up all your old conversations. So with my iPhone 6, I still have it hasn't been backed up. So basically, like, it was just put in the cupboard, so I was able to retrieve all my old convos. Not every single convo. I wasn't able to retrieve the convos whilst it was happening. So I think I have one screenshot, but not whilst he was doing it. Like, when I was confronting him, like, why did you do this? This is actually, you're going to see from the point where I had been to his mum and dad's house to basically cry and say, can you please help me? This guy's literally basically bought a watch on my card. You know, I love him and I trusted him. Like, I just can't believe he's done this to me. Can you help me? And this is where they've tried to help me, la, la, la. So this is the point you will see it at. The problem is, guys, the screen is really, because I'm editing this, the screen is tiny. The screen is tiny. So I may not be able to talk in time with what you're seeing on the screen. It's up to you whether you want to mute me and read for yourself or whether you want me to commentate over. That's completely up to you. And then following this will be the story time. Okay. Like I said, guys, this is not in time. It's not my fault that it's not in time. It is what it is. But you can mute me and read for yourself, or you can listen to my voice while I explain. So I obviously say, you're cruel to me. Anywhere are you going to? Question mark. You keep making me promises. It's like you don't care. DJ, I'm sorry. Don't do this. Let's talk. I'm obviously being pussy. Like, I always thought if I played nice, he would play nice back. But obviously that just showed how weak I was. But anyway, he goes, I don't give a damn. You should do the same. You haven't moved like that. So he obviously is saying that I'm not sorry, and he's upset at me because I've been to his family home. So to snitch on him basically, so that he could help a sister out. Then I'm like, you think I acted quickly, but you didn't put the direct debit. You never switched it into your name. Can we talk about it, please? And then I say, glad you're safe. I have no idea why I've said that. I would do anything for you. I thought that's what you wanted, a rider. So I'm talking about, you know, how much I loved him. La, la, la. How was your trip? Do you want to sort it out? This is me just playing nice. Then he goes, you pick this, lol, good luck. To be honest with you, back then, I thought he was genuinely upset that I went to his parents' house. But now, on reflection, I actually think that he's just deflecting. I think it was an easy way out because he didn't want to pay for the watch. Whatever dodgy plan he had, to make money off this stupidness, it didn't work. It crashed and burned, and he couldn't be asked. So he just kept making his excuses. Then he goes, what's court for? You're robbed. No one's telling me nothing. Talking about us being ruined, and he says he doesn't care. I thought maybe if I could pull into his heartstrings, he would pay off. There you go. He says, good, see you in court. And then there's me saying, I would have died for you. You're an evil pig. I hate your guts. I hate you. He's saying, do you want to get blocked? Oh, it's just really frustrating to read this. Then I said, this is your fault. And then I said, I don't know why I'm saying I moved on. This is me just being a dickhead and a loser. Now this conversation isn't about the watch. This is basically because at this point, guys, me and him are done. So we haven't seen each other for 2 months. So because obviously he's a cheater and a liar and a deceiver and a stealer, a thief. So I write all this stuff about, like, you know, you're evil. I wish I never loved you. And he's saying he's proud. He's proud to be evil. You know, he's proud that he's left me in debt. Absolutely amazing. What a gentleman. Now, guys, I'm going to put maybe the end of this conversation towards the back of the story time. If you're nosy enough to read it, if you're bored enough to read it. But I'm going to stop it here. Hello, everybody. welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Lani. This is not a fun story time, and I've put it off for a very long time. Even when I went viral for Bad Boy, people were like begging me to come on YouTube and explain the story step by step, and I was like, I don't know. I feel like I never thought that I would actually do it, do the actual story time. What you guys have to realize is, as much as DJ did me dirty and hurt me, I still care about him. So when I revealed what I revealed in Bad Boy, I feel like I did it in a lighthearted, banterous way, and I didn't want to do it in a serious manner, like in front of the camera like this, because I guess I wanted to control how much damage it would have or how much impact it would have on, not that I can affect his career, of course not. I'm not trying to say like I'm anything special, but I wanted to control how much my supporters hated him. And of course they may dislike him, but when you don't know the whole story, it's not as deep. So I kind of didn't want anyone to really, really hate him. I just wanted them to be a bit pissed off with him. So that's why I didn't do that. I still feel like, because people were sending me the stuff about that Octavia guy, and I was like, I don't want his career to end, and yeah, I don't. So I want you guys to obviously hear the full story, to understand maybe my pain, maybe why I just really don't give a fuck, like how much the internet drags me, because it's so trivial. Like, you just to understand who I am more as a person. I don't really want people to go and send hate to him after this, simply because, I mean, if you want to send a polite message to him, fair enough, but I would rather my goodies don't send hateful, harmful messages towards him, because I just don't want to be that person, and I don't want to have a very detrimental, negative impact on his mental health or his career. Not that I can, but that wouldn't be my aim, right? I kind of just wanted to teach him a lesson. I kind of just wanted to stand up for myself. Just to show him that, you took me for a punk, but I'm not a punk. I just kind of wanted to stand up for myself and irritate him, but my intentions was never to finish him and end his career. So anyway, with a heavy heart, I guess I sit here and I have to do this unpleasant story time. Yeah, this is just really weird. I feel really, really bare and really exposed telling you guys this, because it's, yeah, really personal, I suppose. Anyway, me and DJ were super close. And when it came to money, there was a level of trust there. DJ, like, for instance, let me hold, like, one time he asked me to hold like a big amount of money for him. Like, he dropped me a couple, I'm not really sure because I never counted the money, but it was just like a big amount of cash. So it could have been 2 grand, it could have been 4, it could have been 5, it could have been 6, I don't know. But he let me hold some money for him, and he came back and got it later.
I'd done a lot of bad things for him on his behalf. I was pretty much really this disgusting ride or die and would just literally do anything for him. I used to also pay for some of his expenses. I'll give you an example. DJ used to sometimes ring me and say, like, I need my phone bill paid, and he'd used to just be like, I don't have like a bank card. So because he was a roadman, he always used to use the bank card as an excuse. He always used to be like, oh, I don't have a bank card, like, I don't have so I don't have access to the bank, my bank card, can you just sort it out for me now? I'll give you cash when I see you. And he always gave me the cash, always gave me the cash. And even if he forgot to, wouldn't be a big deal. A £60, £50 phone bill for your babe is not a big deal. So yeah, he used to ask me to do little favors like that. I went to collect money for him one time. It's just, there was just a certain level of trust in it, like, kind of thing. And we used to have conversations where he used to say, like, because I used to just say, like, you know, do you ever worry about putting me in danger? And he would just be like, I would never ever put you in danger. Like, I would never ever ever ever, like, I would never ever you know, like, do you dirty, or like, just basically, I got you kind of thing, innit? So another example is one time he was in Selfridges and he wanted to buy this Burberry coat. It's a blue Burberry coat with a hood, it's got fur on it. I'm sure I can find a picture and put it up if I look on his Instagram. And he asked me to transfer the money to his bank account. Sorry guys, it was about, it's late, I'm on board. Sorry, it's late. The coat was about 700, 750, something like that. So I transferred the money, and a couple of days later, he paid me back. So I fully trusted him. And where I was so willing, I suppose, to do so much for him, and basically put my life at risk for him, there was this time, I think at this point we'd been seeing each other 7-8 months, and he basically, so I used to drive this old A-class Mercedes, and DJ, he had like his big boy BMW, and I really wanted a new car, but my mum and dad were in Africa because they work there, and like my mum's retired, so I didn't want to go by myself. I wanted to go with a man because I didn't really know like too much about cars. I liked cars based on how they looked on the outside appearance. So I asked DJ, like, could he come with me? And he kept flopping me. And then one day he came to me with this idea where if I got a car, no, basically, he basically said to me, because I was such a good girl and because I was always there for him, he was going to get me a car and pay for it. He was going to pay for the deposit and pay for half my like outgoings every month. And I was like, oh my God, are you sure, babe? But I'm so honored, like, why would you do that? And he was just like, obviously, because you're my babe. He's like, I got you. I wanted an Audi A5 at the time. And we looked at like white ones and black ones, and we were gonna lease a car. So he said to me that he knew someone that worked at the leasing company, so that could get us like a good deal or whatever, like one of his boys or a girl or someone that he knew in it. So I had to fill in a form, I sent it over to DJ, and he sorted it all out. One of the other things to do with this story is DJ also said to me that he wanted me to get him a Porsche in my name because I had good finance. And I just said to him at the time, because it hadn't been that long, that I wasn't 100% comfortable with doing that yet. And maybe in the future, but at the moment I wasn't comfortable with doing that. Like, I just, I didn't know if I could trust him. So I basically said no. And he said, cool. And he said, look, let me get you the Audi and I'll pay, like I said, I'll pay the deposit and I'll pay half, and just let me drive it here and there. And I was just like, oh, are you sure? And obviously he already had this big boy BMW, but he said like he just wanted variety, sometimes drive the BMW, sometimes drive my Audi. Now the car thing never happened. I passed the thing, the test, like it all went fine. I had good credit, but for whatever reason, he just went quiet on the matter. And he stopped asking me to get me a car, even though initially he was extremely pushy. Not pushy in a bad way. He seemed quite excited to get me the car, but then it just went quiet and it went dead. And I found out, I'll tell you at the end what I found out about the car, why it went quiet and why it went dead. But he just stopped talking about it, which is fine. So at this point, guys, what I want you guys to remember is that Tion had my he had all my life details in order to pass the whole process to get a car. You obviously have to fill your name, your age, your NI number, where you work, just like all this stuff, right? To pass, you have to fill in this form quite intensely. And remember, his friend was sorting it out for us, so I sent it through DJ. So DJ had all my details. Of course, DJ knew my name, my date of birth, and where I lived anyway, without the form. But I think it went into more detail, like your NI number, the stuff that he wouldn't have known. Like, did you get it? Unless I filled in this form. So that went quiet for a while. So I feel like I've painted quite a good picture of our relationship and how much I was his ride or die. Another thing is, you know, DJ did, you know, take me to dinners or take me on lunch dates. DJ did spend money on me, like he did spend money on me. And I don't know, I just trusted him with my life, innit? Like, I just really trusted the guy. As dumb as it was, I really trusted the guy. Also, the car situation, I was always a little bit suspicious of it, but I don't know, I guess I thought in my head maybe he's just eager to pay for a car for me because he can't get one on finance and he wants to flex in the streets. So I thought, whatever, at the end of the day, do you know what I mean? And if he fucks off, at least it's my car at the end of the day, do you know what I mean? Like, if he left me with the debt, it's my car, it's not his. So I guess the car situation wasn't too alarming. So this brings me to the watch situation. So one day DJ rang me, and I was at work. I used to work in Cricklewood for a events company called, I don't know how to say the name, but it was some events company in Cricklewood. I don't even think they exist anymore, but I used to work over there. So one day DJ rang me at lunch-ish and basically said to me, babes, do you mind if I buy something on your card? And I said, I don't have any money, because obviously I didn't. I was on 22 grand at the time. I was broke. I didn't have the money. But he was like to me, no, don't worry about it, man. I'm going to put the money in your account, innit? Like, I want to buy something for me, but I don't have access to, like, my bank card, or my bank's always being funny with me. So I'm going to transfer all the P's into your account, and then I'm going to buy myself this gift. Now, remember, you know, I had transferred to you on 750 before and the car. So I don't know. There's a certain level of trust. So I was like to him, okay, babe. And I think in my head, where I was broke, very broke, I didn't have any money, I kind of thought, like, what's he gonna do? Steal 60 quid out of my account, steal 80 quid out of my account, you know? There wasn't much in there, so I just thought, fuck it. You know, this is my babes, and I trust him, and he's got me, so. I gave him my bank card so he could buy his present after he transferred the money. So I was very aware that he was using my card to buy himself a present. Anyway, day, he said to me, I'm gonna come yours to see you. And I was like, okay, babes. So he came mine. He was really excited to see me, like, more than usual. So I was just thinking, rah, like, what's happened? Why are you so excited to see me? And then the next morning, he woke up and he basically said to me, like, early in the morning, like, oh, I got something, I'm coming here, innit? Like, because I was already going to be with you, so I thought I'll get it delivered to yours, innit? Like, so can I open the door? Like, I don't want you to open the door. So I was like, okay, that's cool, babe. And he was like, yeah, don't open the door. And my sister lived there at the time, so he was like, tell your sister not to open the door, innit? I'll go get the delivery. I said, no problem, darling. So obviously, like, I told my sister, she said, cool, innit? Like, he wants to open his delivery or whatever. So this had never happened before. He had never ever bought anything to mine, but I just didn't put two and two together. So he came upstairs, he had a green box, it was a Rolex. Now I'm thick as fuck because I still don't put two and two together. I kind of thought that maybe it's the thing that he bought himself yesterday, but it was only, he only put $2,000 in my account, so it can't be a Rolex. Rolex is not $2,000. I don't know, I was just thick. So, anyway, took pictures with it, even I took pictures with it, and we moved on. 2 weeks later, I was at work again, and my sister called me, and she goes, because my sister used to open my letters because I was just lazy for letters. So she, every day she used to open my letters. So she rang me because I used to stay late at work. So it was maybe 6-ish and she was already home. And she goes, hey, I'm at home. And she goes, do you know that DJ took a Rolex out in your name on direct debit? And my heart sank. My heart sank. Because I thought, what? And I just went into panic mode and my body, like, I just had a panic attack. And my issue was, it was scary because he didn't tell me he was gonna put a direct debit that lasts 3-4 years on my account. That conversation never happened. So I didn't know what to feel because my body was telling me something's wrong. Like he done this, it's fucked. Like he's trying to, he's got bad intentions or he doesn't love you. He's trying to do you wrong. But then my heart's telling me, no, DJ would never do that to me. It must be some mistake. So I rang him and I was just like obviously panicking and he was just like, babes. And this is what gets me and this is what upsets me, yeah? He was like, oh, babes, like, he was like, babes, I will never do you dirty. I got you. He actually kind of like acted like, rah, like, really, Lani? Like, I know I done it, but like, don't worry, like, I got you. So I was like, so why did you do it? And he was just like to me, don't worry, I've got a plan. And then he didn't really go into detail, but he basically kind of suggested that this was all like a scheme of some sort, but he just used me. And he was just like, trust me, in a couple weeks or a month or so, this is all gonna be patterned. And you won't have to worry about it. I'm gonna sort it out for you, man. Like, basically, like, he had a plan with the watch. Like, he had some dodgy plans, innit? So he just was like, when it all like falls through and everything's patterned, you won't have to worry about this watch. I'm gonna look after you. So Tion then ended up, because we had to wait. Well, I didn't have a choice. I had to wait for this plan. He ended up paying, I think he paid three installments. He used to give me the cash It was about £310 or something, £330. So he would give me the cash and I would go put it in my bank account, and that's how he would reimburse me. And he did that for 3 months. And then we had a disagreement to deal with another girl who told me that she was his girlfriend. Obviously, at the time, I thought I was his girlfriend. So that didn't go down too well. So me and him started beefing. Me and him fell out big time. And when I reached out to him to pay the fourth installment, he just aired me. He just ignored me. He didn't give a fuck. At the time, I think my sister had been made redundant, so I had to look after both of us, and I was begging him to pay, begging him to sort it out, and he just didn't give a fuck. He just didn't care. No matter how much I cried, no matter how much he just didn't care. I ended up going to mum and dad's house to tell them, to like snitch on him. And they tried to help me. They took my number down. They were texting me, and the help lasted about a week and a half, and then they just graciously bowed out. I don't know what he said to them, but they were nice enough to say, we will help you, we'll get him to transfer it all into his name. And then I don't know what he said to them, but they just very, very politely decided to bow out. Yeah. So my thing is this. I am not upset at DJ for doing it to me. I've forgiven him for that. My thing is more, sorry, I was just like reading his tweets, right? Where he said like, where he said that there's females that has had him his whole career and they need to know that he doesn't condone the fuckery that I'm claiming, right? But what that makes me feel is like, it makes me feel lesser than, because I wonder like, what did I do to deserve to get robbed? How come What did I do wrong compared to those other girls? Because the other girls, he says that have had him, he doesn't condone that, so obviously he didn't do it to them. I just feel like, a part of me feels like, why me? Like, how come? DJ, why did you do it to me? He didn't rob, but a lot of the girls he dated, he didn't do it to them. Was I stupid? Was I an easy target? Guys, that's my main concern. I just want to heal because I can't let what DJ did to me make me never find love. I find it hard to make connections with people, which is why I haven't really let him go in essence. Like, I've seen him since 4 years ago. We've met up and had sex. I can't let him go because I can't get over the trauma. Because I just feel like, why me? I just want to be loved, yeah? Everyone just wants to be loved, yeah? I know you guys see how I am now, but back then I was nice. I was perfect for you. I cook for you, I clean for you, I stayed home. Why, DJ? I've seen you online buying handbags for your fans, but you fucked me. Why, DJ? Why? I forgive you for doing it. I just wanted you to come back and fix it. I just wanted you to say sorry. And mean it, and make it up to me. To say that other girls who have had you and you don't condone it, why me then? Why me? What was wrong with me? What was wrong with me? What was wrong with me? I was good to you. I was loyal to you, I only saw you. Why did you do it to me? Why did you never come back and fix it? At this point, guys, I have to move on. I have to leave it in God's hands. It's not about the money. I loved him. I loved him so much. And he knows that. I just wanted to be sorry. I just wanted him to be sorry. I matter. I know you're a big time rapper, but my life matters. I matter. I matter. You can't do me dirty and think I'm gonna take it down like a fucking punk. I'm not going to. I'm gonna fight back. I don't care where I end up fighting you. I don't care where I end up. If I end up 6 foot under, so be it. If you and your boys want to pull up on me and kill me, do it. I'm ready to die for this shit because I matter. You can't rob me and think I'm not going to stand up for myself. It's never going to be that because I matter. The day that my feelings for you started to like subsidize, started to like, sort of like disappear a little bit, the day I loved you less, the day like that's when my head started to clear, and that's when I deep, like, this guy took the piss out of me, and this guy ain't never been sorry. You was a meal ticket. That's when I deeped it. What you done to me was fucked. And I just can't get over the fact that you never come back to pattern me, but you will apologize for, or you'll try pattern the Chinese guy because you squeezed his head. You apologize for the guy that you stomped on his. You do bear shit to other people, to randoms, because you care about your image. But you robbed me, and I was a real girl. You were fucking. Fair enough, you might have not cared about me, but I didn't deserve that. I didn't deserve it. I didn't fucking deserve it. And I'm not fucking taking it. I'm not taking it lying down. That's why I've fucking done a YouTube videos on it. It's just to teach you a lesson. Even if you don't give a fuck, even if you don't give a fuck, let this YouTube, let the views of this YouTube pay me back, because you fucking did that to me. You left me with your fucking debt, going to Dubai and all these other countries with my money, with other girls. You were fuckery to me, and I'm gonna stand up for myself, because that is who I am. I am not a dickhead. I am not a punk. My mum did not give birth to me because I'm a cunt. I'm not a cunt. You can't rob me and think it's okay. You can't do that. You fucking robbed me. You fucking cunt. That's what you fucking done to me. And then you think I'm not gonna stand up for myself. I am going to stand up for myself, because I'm worthy, because I'm God's child. But I should get the help I need. You should have robbed me. And that's the end of that. I don't hate you. I don't wish you bad. But just know, I done this for me, for my healing, because I need to love myself. And the only way I can love myself is when I know, Lani, you know what, sis? You stood up for yourself, and I fucking stood up for myself. And all the fucking videos I've done on your fucking name are gonna pay me back for my fucking watch. That's not your fucking watch, it's my fucking watch, okay? I've stood up for myself, and I'm proud of myself. No matter what you think of me, I'm proud of myself, because I'm not a fucking dickhead. You can't take me for idiot. You can't fucking bully me. You can't treat me like I'm nothing. You can't treat me like I'm worthless. You can't do it. You cannot fucking do it. I'm not having it. You fucking robbed me, and I've stood up for myself, okay? I've told the whole internet. Your fucking fans who are already obsessed with you and in love with you, they'll never believe me. Even if I fucking have you on tape, even if I have you on tape doing shit, you will still be there. They'll still be there licking your ass because they love you. But this isn't about the internet. This isn't about them. This is about us. You did me dirty, and I stood up for myself. I don't wish bad on you. I hope you have a successful career, because at the end of the day, you worked hard for your career, and I will always have a soft spot for you, because I was in love with you, you fucking cunt. Do you not get that into your thick skin? I was fucking in love with you. So I will never wish bad on you. I want you to be happy. I want you to succeed. But that does not mean you have to walk on people like me to get there. It can never be that. And I'm not a dickhead. I'm not taking it lying down. Like I said, if I end up in a body bag 6 foot under because I stood up for myself, so be it. Because I'll go into that body bag proud that I stood up for myself. Nothing else matters but my mental health and me healing. Nothing else matters, and that's on period, and that's the fucking end of this bullshit, okay? If I want to send for you in my music, if I want to fucking send for you randomly, I will do that. I have not done this to cancel you. I have not done this for clout. You have mentally tapped me because of how deep you broke my heart. Fuck leaving me. The fact that you left me in debt is what really fucking hurt. The debt really fucking hurt. And this is how I'm going to fucking heal. You don't have to understand this. No one watching this has to understand this. You can all suck your fucking mums if you don't understand that I am healing through this. Standing up for myself, for me, is loving myself. Giving myself what I'm worth. This is what I'm worth. I'm worth standing up for myself, telling my story, not being a cunt, not being a dickhead, not letting anybody rob me for £8,000, have bailiffs coming to my fucking door. Bailiffs coming to my fucking door. I'm just taking it, lying down like some punk. I'm not doing it. This shit happens all day long. All day long, this type of shit happens. Girls have been finessed. Girls have been beaten up. Girls have been abused. There's so much shit girls go through, yeah? And girls just take it lying down. No. 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 No, it's not happening. It's not happening around here. It's not happening around here. So I stood up for myself. I don't give a fuck what anyone has to fucking say. You can't tell me shit because a nigga didn't fucking rob you. You can't tell me shit. If you not come on my page saying, grow up, oh, give it a rest, fuck you. Fuck you, because the vim I have in me, you will never fucking understand. I will sing until I'm tired of singing, until my lungs hurt. You was a fucking robbed, yeah? So go fucking suck your mummy fucking cunt. That's all I'm gonna say, and that's on period. Now, on to bigger and better things, all I have to say is this. Y'all don't have to go send hate for Tion because, yeah, cool. Where did I even end the story? Like, yeah, he left me with the receipts. I had to go get a lawyer, by the way, guys, which I had to pay for. The lawyer was able to get some of the bailiffs off my back. But till this day, because I stopped paying. So I think the watch was worth 10 grand and the deposit was 2. Still to this fucking day, I get letters, I get threats, I get bailiffs because he hasn't paid off the watch, because he hasn't put it in his name, because he just doesn't give a shit about me, and he never did. And I just feel like I can't lie. I can't be fake with you guys and think and say, oh, fuck him, I don't care about him. I will always care about him. I will always have some sort of love for him, from a distance, of course. But I needed to do this for me. I needed to do this for me to heal. Yeah, it's not really about you lot believing me or not, but some of you lot believe me. Some of you lot know I'm telling the truth. You don't have to cancel the guy. You don't have to not listen to his music. I just had to do what I had to do for me. And I feel good about that. And that's on period. Fuck him. And that's just fuck him. Like, what he done to me was fucking foul. And let me just say this, because I said it in some of my story times. Tion has, by the way, when we met up afterwards, like after that happened, when we met up at different periods, he met up with me and he would fuck me and he would say, oh, obviously, man, sorry for how he treated you. But at the same time, the reason I never ever think that was sincere apology is because you're up now. You are up, my nigga. And you have never run me back the peas. What about the babes coming to my mom's house? Like, come on, my nigga. Like, it is what it is. Like I said, guys, this is the last story time I'm gonna do on Tion. It's the last story time I'm gonna do on Tion, unless I feel the need to. I really would appreciate you not sending hate to him, because it's just gonna probably make him, you know, talk shit and act like a fool, and I can't be arsed. So can you just leave him? Just like, he's not gonna pay me back in it, so fuck him. Like, just leave him. I feel like these videos have helped pay me somewhat back, not fully, but somewhat. I've got some of the money back, and I can only be grateful to God for that, and for giving me this platform, and for giving me my family, and for giving me my goodies who support me and love me and ride out with me. And let me tell you something, goodies, if you like a Tion Wayne track, trust me, sis, it's no skin off my bone. I don't hate you. It doesn't mean that you're not a goodie. Trust me, you don't even have to hide it. It's not, this war is has nothing to do with you. This is a war between me and him. You can still support Tion. Support him if you want to. It doesn't mean shit, darling. It doesn't mean, trust me, guys, it doesn't mean that I won't think you're a real one or you're a rider. I still love you regardless. If you love me, I love you. People are flawed. The nigga did something to me. He's a bit trash. He's flawed. Doesn't mean that I want his life to end. I have faith that one day he will become a better person. And a lot of you guys might look at me and think, yeah, he only did dirty things to you because you're this, because a lot of you don't like me. But, you know, I'm not the only person who's a victim of Tion's. So my hope in all of this, besides my healing, is that Tion does become a better person. That's it. I just want to become They're so shocked when they hear this drop, cause I